What's up, everybody? Back with another Herbal Reactions. About to watch another episode of Mayfair Witches. Episode 2. That first episode was... It was pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. It was good. It was good. It was just good. That's it. It wasn't great. It wasn't like... it was good. I fucked with it. Had the little demon and all that shit in there. Had her kill people with the thought of her mind and shit. You know? But yeah, other than that, let's just hop right in. I will keep your daughter safe. He alright. He be alright.
Suzanne! Let's just move below Bob and Bird Dog. And take your sister with you. Quick now, before it turns dark.
I will call 911, but I forgot the number. Her life.
Cornflower.
Cornflower.
Salvia. That's right. No, not that one. There's something Kenny touched to you no more.
Oh, really?
Ready? Close your eyes and recite for me the names of every herb we've picked today. No. Go. No.
Don't make me wait.
You're already waiting.
Penny Royal.
I was about to say.
After I lost my father, I'm not ashamed to admit it took me a couple of weeks to remember which end of the scalpel was up.
With all due respect, I've done 6 procedures since Monday, all positive outcomes.
Yeah, I looked at those tapes. On average, your patients have been under anesthesia 1.3 times longer than they were in the past. It's a significant increase.
That's still faster than anyone else on the team.
You're not on your game, Rowan. Let yourself take a break.
Please, Dr. Keck. Just tell me what I need to do to get back on the rotation.
Two floors up. Dr. Davis on the psych team. She gives you the all clear. You're back in business.
I gotta stretch. I need me a jacket like that. Or a overcoat like that. Or whatever it's called. Where you learn to do that?
I'm just gonna ask you a few questions. You can answer as long or short as you like. Ask away. How are you sleeping? Good. Pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
And emotionally, are you feeling anxious, volatile? Any mood swings? I'd have to say no. You lost your mother 2 weeks ago. Yet you haven't missed a day of work. Honestly, I'm at my best when I'm working. And that's why I'm hoping you'll let me get back to it soon. I'm hoping so too, Rowan. Tell me, what is it about work that makes you feel better? Healing people. Nothing feels better than that. I agree. That's what I like about being a doctor too. You've been through a great deal of trauma, and there's nothing wrong with acknowledging that. I have acknowledged it. I was at my mother's grave yesterday and I cried. Is that what you want to hear? It's one way to grieve. Talking is another. Tell me about Daniel Limley.
Who?
Daniel Limley. It says you were present when he died.
Why is that in my work file? Did Keck put that in there?
Tell me what's upsetting you.
What's upsetting me is his death had nothing to do with me.
But you were there. You witnessed it. That must have been hard.
Death every day.
In a hospital? Sure. In a controlled setting, not unexpectedly when you... Ugh.
Are you okay?
Oh, Jesus. I get these all the time. Just give me a second. Sorry.
Right. See?
I'm just imagining that even for a seasoned surgeon like yourself.
Yeah, fuck that. Fuck that. I wouldn't want him to have that power. And what? Hell no. That's your car, ain't it? The mark of the beast. That's some hoodoo, bruh. That's some real shit right there, bruh. Put it in the car? I mean, you did just put it in your whatever, like your coat or whatever, like. Burn them? What in the... You gonna bury them? You gonna dissect them? Oh, my life in Christ. She's burying. Oh, my God. That's fun. She burying the fucking crows. The crows? You gonna sleep there, huh? Oh, hell no. You the wicked witch of the east.
This way. Rowan, this way.
Mom, I'm coming.
Oh, hey, what the hell is that?
Rowan, over here.
Mom, no! Wait! No! Mom, don't leave!
That's not your mom.
Where are you going?
Rowan.
Mom.
I don't know, Samir. I'm really struggling with this one. She needs to know who she is.
Until we know more about her, our job is to observe.
I have observed, and she's scared as hell. She's lost in the woods.
Except she killed someone.
Gonna do some blood magic. God damn. I'm gonna just be real. He must have untracked that phone, because that shit been on for the longest. And I doubt she actually, here we go. I doubt she turned that, fuck. Turned the location shit off on my phone. I couldn't finish that. Tito's. Nasty ass. She a nasty ass motherfucker, bro. Drinking Tito's. Aren't you supposed to be comatose in a fucking wheelchair? Somebody gonna pop up on your ass. Oh, here we go.
Left this room and I'm already tired.
I will give you strength. Now rest. We'll leave in the morning.
What if it's too late?
It won't be. She's coming to us. I've been in her dreams, leading her here.
No, that's what happened.
You're more beautiful now than you've ever been.
That's something nice to say. She's fucking a demon. ain't even there. She got bragging rights just like Sam Winchester. Did Dean? I don't remember. Did Dean get down with a demon? I know he got down with an angel. He got down with an angel. He got bragging rights too. You felt that too? Ah, shit. Yeah, I wouldn't want to be a witch or a warlock. A wizard, however.
We had that family of raccoons living in the walls, all those noisy little babies Mr. Statler had to put down. It sounded just like the sounds I heard coming from your room last night.
A wizard, however, or a sorcerer.
Where is my raincoat? It
should be by the door.
Well, I know where it should be. The storm.
Being a sorcerer, you're kind of like more naturally powerful, but a wizard, you're like more wiser and like have more control over your powers and shit like that. I would probably rather be a wizard. Though, hey, sorcerers are strong too, bruh. And if you're not a good wizard, you can't do shit. Or you can't do much. There's a lot in the fantasy kingdom, man. Some people would like to be knights. Some people want to be elves. You know? Some people just have to be dwarves. Or they could be something else.
Teacher?
Uh-huh. Gotcha.
Please.
Ah, shit. If I was her, I'd be like, get the fuck out of here, motherfucker. Bye. I've been by your side for about, like, I don't even know how long, and you haven't moved a muscle, and now you walking? Oh, hell, yeah, you better run, because if you don't, I will. And when you come back, I won't be here. No. I wonder if we're going to see Lestat. I hope we see him at least one time. Louis. No, I don't think we should see Louis or Armand. I think they should be in Dubai. I don't think they should be. Because last time we seen them, they was in Dubai. Last time we seen Lestat, it was in New Orleans. So at some point, probably in like episode 6 or 7, Lestat should show up.
First time in New Orleans.
As a cameo.
Miss Fielding?
Dr. Fielding.
Like this one. And hotels in particular are vectors for the dead.
Here are your room keys. Two of them. Thank just you. In case.
Hey, I know this is a little weird and a long shot, but do you recognize this house?
That house rings no bells.
Okay. Thank you.
Enjoy your stay.
Thanks.
Doctor.
Deidre? It can't be. It's really you.
Uncle Cortland.
When they told me you were at the door, I thought, why am I dreaming? My God, look at you. After all these years.
We both got old, didn't we?
It's not right. The way she kept you like that. Oh, I should have never let you go.
I need your help.
Well, whatever I can do, I will. But, where is he?
After all this time, I still never know.
Well, what matters is that you're here. You're here. So let's get you cleaned up.
You're here. You're here. God damn, bruh. I wonder how deep of the lore she's gonna go. I wonder if she's gonna get a wand. But she say they call she. Oh no. Witches and wizards are supposed to have like wands to, you know, conjure their magic. But she's more, she seems more like a sorcerer that doesn't need all that, but like a, like a medallion or something like that.
Witches, vampires, demons. Oh, honey, we make up all kinds of hooey on these toys. Folks slop it up with a biscuit.
They ain't saying no werewolves.
Do you think maybe you could take a little detour and point that house out to me?
Tour leaves at 5.
Great.
There she is. Such a pretty thing. You know, that is my daughter's old dress.
When I was a child, you used to buy me dresses just like this every year for my birthday. Do you remember?
Of course, of course.
No.
That's fucking, nah, I'm cool on that. I'm cool on that. Shit, I'd rather be a vampire than that. There's no point of having that. There's no point. Shit.
Here.
I'll have my driver take you.
She's gonna get a knock at the door. Creepy. Are you gonna answer that? You gonna answer his phone?
Hello.
I need to see you right away. Shaken up, but yeah, I'm alive.
Who are you?
God. Here. just miss each other. Tenth fucking floor. Fuck that. First two. I need the first two. Hello. Oh. What the fuck? Okay, guys. Okay. Hold up. Who the hell just slit her throat? Was it the demon? Was it the daughter or was it herself? What the fuck? I don't know, man. That shit was kind of crazy. I did not expect that whatsoever. Like, what the fuck? That was a long ass time. Like, why the fuck? That was a long ass flight, for one. And two, he didn't call his phone in none of that time. And if I was her, I'd have at least checked on the nigga. At least. Are you alive? You're alive? Yeah, I'm a little shaken up, but what you mean? I mean, couldn't find him anyway. I mean, could have waited for him to call. Oh, no. But I hope y'all liked the reaction. If you did, like and subscribe. Let me know what you think of this episode. Or let me know what you want me to watch next. And if you want to support the channel, please join the Patreon. All my full reactions are going to be uploaded there. And as always, thanks for watching. Deuces.